Welcome to workshop two, and this is an oil painting workshop. It's the continuation from the drawing stage, and what we're going to do now is add a little bit of colour into our painting. Okay, now that I'm more or less happy with the drawing, I'm going to add a stain onto it now to help to give me some tonal values. So this is just raw umber with white spirits. I'm not using a huge amount of paint, and I don't want to rub too heavily on the canvas because I don't want to lose the drawing that I have. So it's just a stain. I'm not adding quite so much over the band because with a little bit more pigment to this helps to preserve the drawing just a little if you let it dry. Absolutely happy.
pull some of that down here now to soften this edge. It's quite soft right to that point. And it's quite dark just around here. Jugular coming down and curving out at that point. We've got the clavicle coming across here, and it's tilted down. It comes across again. We'll do a bit more work on that later. Just a tiny hint of shadow just on the philtrum. And I'm just going to darken the upper lip just a tiny bit. I'm going to soften this edge here. And I'm going to add a sort of hint of the plane of the head there. And bring that down. We have highlight just around there. It's really nice to have the position of that. And we're going to pull some shadow down here as well. Not a huge amount. Can't compete with anything on the shadow side here. And I want the form of the chin. Ooh. The form of the chin to be there, forms a okay. So here's my palette again. It's titanium white, cadmium red, cadmium yellow, pale hue. Now I'm just going to take some of the darker tone and pop that in over the shadow side. Just down here. I've already more or less indicated where the shadow tones are going to go. It's going to be a bit warmer, so I will be adding some extra warmth into that by injecting some red in. Lighter just there, and it's going to be darker in some areas as well, darker and warmer. Usually what happens is if the light side is warm, then the shadow side is going to be cool. So there's one thing I always have to remind myself of when I'm painting. And that is the color lighter or darker? Is it warmer or cooler? And if I stick to that question in my head, I don't want the light side to compete with the shadow side either. Like, this side of the face has to be darker on the right hand side than the left hand side, simply because the light source is coming from the left. Again, I'm just using the darker tone just for the moment. It's the mid-tone, really. usually there would be about five different values. That's five different lights and darks in a painting. Like five different values to complete a whole painting. Too, so I'm adding a little bit of the lighter tone now, just coming down this section here, around here, and the eye, the light is just around that section there, so keep that clearer. And I'm going to bring this down. At that point. And there's light catching that side of the philtrum. And I'll just bring that down. And I'm going to work a little light back into this area. Okay. I'm going to use the same value or a variation of it. Just for this lighter section, just here. So before this dries, I want to soften the edges here. So I'm doing a zigzag and blending. I don't want to sort of lose the planes, so you don't want to pull too much of the light into the darker area. And the darker area is going to have a slightly darker accent in some places, certainly around there too. And for those darker accents, I'm going to take some raw umber, some ivory black, and mix that in. It's like a slight purpley hue of it. And I'm going to put that down. And I want it to overlap here a little. Because I want to increase the amount of purple tone, I'm adding in a hint of the ultramarine blue now into the red. It won't give me a vivid purple. It'll give me a color that will read cooler for these accents. It's warmer purple. I'm adding some brown and black into this as well. I'm just gonna draw that around here. I think it could be warmer than that, a bit more red. Is it lighter? Is it darker? Is it warmer? Is it cooler? That's a mantra that goes through my head when I'm painting. Warmer accent around the eye here as well. Possibly a hint more ochre into it with oil paint. You start with your darker tones and work your way up to the brighter ones. Skin tone mix for the shadow side of the lip. The lips are going to be a mixture of the skin tone, the yellow ochre, red and white, plus a little extra red. Just absorb into that flesh color now. Not for the moment, anyway. It's important to keep the lips soft, the edges soft. Still a bit strong with the red there. That's better. Just using a soft brush. as well as there. Blocking in the shadow that the eyelid creates on the sclera, the white of the eye. Some of that, also that darker tone, it's just raw umber black. I'm gonna add some of that, paying attention to the photograph, looking at the angles, making sure I have them correct. Did a bit of correcting on those values. It should be warmer on this side. I'm adding a little extra red in. More than that, maybe a little white, bit of the skin tone, even a bit more. Eyebrow is lighter over that section where the highlight is strongest. Oops, too dark, not warm enough. Is it lighter? Is it darker? Is it warmer? Is it cooler? give definition to the neck, and that also has to be a soft edge, a soft transition. Using a variation, it's actually the darker skin tone, believe it or not, for the hair. We'll work into that with lights then. I'm just going to mass in some of the background now, like with the cadmium red. Maybe a bit of raw umber on the far side. Massing it. I'll use a little bit of medium, not too much. Tiny bit, just to help the paint to flow. I haven't cleaned my brush, so medium, it also makes the paint transparent, and I don't necessarily want that too much just for the moment. It's okay, but if it was too transparent, you would still see too much of the lines come through. Use a bigger brush. still need some of that to be present. As the light is coming across this side, the light's gonna catch the filtrum here on this side, then it gets darker, and then as it curves back out on the far side, it starts to darken. A little bit of light along the lower lid, just around here. Eyelid. Be darker. More black. Dark, more red. And it's and across here, straighter. And then side of the filter. Her face and her eyelid on this side. It's slightly brighter. A bit more dark just here, just to emphasize the edge of the band. Okay, I want to add in a hint more warmth just at that point. Soften the edge. used here. Tie it up with that. And then a hint of into an edge of the nose. Come down slightly lower than the clavicle, and this has to soften in here. And I'm going to lose a little bit of the information just at that point. That's more like it. Soften. Softening that there, softening it here. It's warmer just here. Oh, yeah. It's quite nice, but it's a bit bright, a bit warm. Jugular and soften it in here. The edge shouldn't be sharp. Okay, so I'm just going to add a few finishing touches. I'm going to go over the red now with a more vibrant color. And I'm going to darken it on the left-hand side of the canvas. Okay, so I'm just going to do a few little finishing touches. I'm sure there's tons I could do on this painting, but I think it's resolved enough. using my grandfather's walking stick as a mahl stick, since I don't put my hand on the canvas. She has gone to the trouble of putting eyelashes on. Or put them in. I think that one's a bit too defined, so I'm just going to tonk it with a bit of tissue paper. That should dull it down a little and soften the edge a bit too. Okay. I think what I'll do is I'll put in the earrings. So there's a grey tone there, so I'm just mixing some black white. I'm dropping a hint of red into it as well. Too much red. Was a little sharper. So I'm mixing a bit of flesh tone because I cleaned it off the palette. I'm just gonna mix up a slightly yellower tone than I used. Plenty of white. And it needs to be dulled down, and I'm just going to use a little tiny hint of raw umber to do that. So the grey tone for the earring, it's basically black and white, tiny hint of red. Comes in around that point. have to restate the dark there now. Okay, I'm just going to add some lights into that there. Just adding the highlights in. I'm going to restate that one. Yeah. The top of it catches the light. And it is brighter here as well. I don't want to draw attention to them at all. We have to look like they're, especially this one, it has to look like it's emerging out from the shadow. I'm just going to hint red eye. Tiny hint of skin tone. Finito. Thank you.